Hey, let's talk about the calls to free Larry Hoover and what this whole situation is about. What you have to understand is that Larry Hoover is sitting in a federal supermax penitentiary because he was sentenced to life in prison for selling crack. Now, he also has a separate state case that we're going to talk about. But first, you have to free Larry Hoover on his federal drug dealing charges, okay? Larry Hoover has spent 25 years in a federal supermax facility, which means that for 25 years, he has spent between 20 to 24 hours of every day sitting in a room completely by himself with no other human contact, no activity, no ability to leave that small cell, like 7 foot by 12 foot, for 20 to 24 hours a day for the past 25 years for selling drugs. As a citizen of the United States, I am appalled and I am ashamed that my government would sentence a drug dealer to that type of punishment. It's outrageous. You have to let Larry Hoover out of Supermax. Second, a life sentence for selling crack. Look, Larry Hoover was selling a lot of crack. According to the pre-sentence report, his criminal enterprise was making $100 million a year selling crack, moving several kilos a day. Fine, okay, that's not life in prison, okay? As far as I'm concerned, no drug dealer, no matter how much drugs they're selling, gets life in prison, okay? Because drugs on the street are as big a problem because of the broken fucking system we live in as it is because of drug dealers who choose to go sell it. Life in prison for drugs? Absolutely not. Supermax, where you spend 20 or 24 hours alone? Absolutely not. Donald Trump passed a law that said, you know what, some of the sentences that we gave to crack offenders make no sense. It's crazy. So Donald Trump passed the First Step Act, which allows judges and prosecutors to review previous sentences issued to crack dealers and give new sentences out where appropriate. This is a case where it's appropriate to give him a new sentence. He should not only be let out of Supermax, he should be resentenced to time served on the federal narcotics conspiracy charge because he has paid his debt to society. Interestingly, when this argument was made to a judge by Hoover's lawyers about a year ago, the judge seemed willing and understanding of it, and he definitely was ready to let Larry Hoover out. However, the judge expressed hesitation because Mr. Hoover had not recanted his membership in the gang. He had not expressed remorse for the violence that had been committed, the pain caused by the drugs that he had sold. And the judge basically suggested, you know what, if you do that, Mr. Hoover, and you come back to me, I'll let you out on these federal charges. If Larry Hoover does get out on the federal charges, he still has to deal with a state murder conviction from back in the 1970s. Now, I'm not saying that Larry Hoover should get out on that, but what I do know is this. A man who has served more than 50 years on a crime like that, a man who was convicted of that crime when he was extremely young, is eligible under our laws to have a parole review. If the federal government does the right thing and resentences him under the First Step Act, he gets the opportunity to apply for parole, and at a minimum, you have to free Larry Hoover on the federal charges and let him have his shot at parole at the state level.